Hey there, community. In this video, I'm going to explain what an API is and how prevalent they are in your life, whether you know it or not. We'll then get into the basics of what an API traffic flow looks like as we talk through an example application. And then we're actually going to crack open the payload just a little bit and see what data an API might be moving around. So API is an acronym for Application Programming Interface. Applications can have these application programming interfaces or APIs and use them to communicate with each other. But APIs are more than just a communication tool for software. You can think of them as a developer interface. Developers use APIs to interact with applications. This could be building an API to offer up information, or a developer may build an application to consume information from someone else's API. You interact with thousands of APIs every day. An example is, say you're planning a trip and searching online for London, UK. When that next web page loads, bringing you information about London, it will pull images from, say, the Google Photos API, local weather from a weather service API. It'll pull airline information from, say, the Google Travel API. It might show you maps from the Google Maps API and provide guidance about the tube in London from their API. On that same page, you may choose to purchase a trip from them using the PayPal API. And you may post about your experience using the share button, which posts to social media using their API. So you can see how APIs bring together a number of separate functions in order to deliver on a rich overall application experience. So what does it look like when you interact with an API? Think of an experience of going to a bank teller. Now, depending on your age, this may be your parents going to a bank teller to withdraw money. You go into a bank, you ask for help. But before you get that help from the teller, you must provide identification, proving that it's you. Once that's verified, you tell them your bank account number and the amount you're withdrawing. The bank takes that information, processes the transaction, and the result is that you get your money and a receipt. Now, for an API request and response, it's actually very similar to that transaction. So let's keep on this bank scenario. The client in this case is actually a mobile application, or it could be a web page. It sends a withdrawal request to the banking API. The request will include a form of ID, credentials, and information letting the API know what you'd like to do. The request is then routed to the appropriate part of the application, which processes withdrawals. The request is processed and the API returns a response, and it indicates whether or not that transaction went well or if there was an issue. So what might this request look like if we kind of dive into the API a little bit? We're going to use a type of API called REST. Now, REST stands for Representational State Transfer. Nobody calls it that though, just say REST. Now, what's gonna happen is there will be a REST API call, and this is the request going into the API. The main part of the REST API call looks just like a URL, like you would put into your browser. There's a domain, and in this case, we'll say bank.example.com. Then in the URL, you'll often see a version of the API that you want to access, along with the type of transaction you'd like to do in this scenario. Now that I've sent the API the guidance to what I'm looking to accomplish, let's give it the data that it's going to need in order to fulfill this request. REST API services are usually expecting this data structured in a format called JSON, another acronym which stands for JavaScript Object Notation. In this example, I need to provide a username, an authentication token. Think of this as like a password, the source account number, and the amount of money that I want to withdraw. Once we submit this information, the API service has everything it needs to process the request and responds in the same JSON format with a status of the transaction. This example shows a way that developers will build interactions with APIs into their applications, but note that your interaction isn't with the API. Instead, it's with whatever human-friendly interface is presented to you, whether that's a web page or your mobile app on your phone. The web page or mobile app takes your inputs and then turns them into API calls in order to interact with all of these other services, not something that most people realize. In fact, today, around 80% of the traffic on the internet are API calls, and 90% of developers use APIs. So I hope this was a good introduction to the basic concepts of an API. We have more videos on the DevCentral channel exploring this topic, which I will link, but I'll also encourage you to explore and search through the channel. There's lots of good stuff on there. If you haven't already, click like if you like this video. Click subscribe and enable the notification bell if you want to be the first to know when we've released a new video. And otherwise, thanks for watching, and I will see you on the next one.